Hey everyone. In this video, we're going to be talking about the date function in Microsoft Excel. In this video, we'll talk about what this function is and how to use it. Implementing and manipulating dates within Microsoft Excel is incredibly powerful and useful. In Microsoft Excel, the date function is a built-in function that allows us to work with dates and perform various operations on them. It's an essential tool for managing time-related data in our spreadsheets. To get started, let's take a look at the syntax of the date function. We can do this by simply typing equals date and then hitting tab, or typing a right bracket. Then clicking our blue title here. Excel tells us that the function takes three arguments: the year, the month, and the day. By providing these values, we can generate a date based on the input. Therefore, as an example, let's say that we want to have February 1st, 2022 as a date. We'll type equals date, tab, and our year, 2022. Our month, which are given as a 1 to 12. Since February is the second month, we will put 2. Then lastly, we have the day, which is going to be a 1 for the first day of the month. Now, before we go through some of the more practical applications of how you can use these dates, I just want to show you quickly how you can change the way in which the date is presented. So, I'll just drag this formula down and duplicate it. Clicking our second date and heading up to this number button here, we can change the way in which our date is presented from a short date to a long date. Likewise, if you want more options, just go to the bottom here and click on Number Formats, and you can see many options on the dates, and you can format the data however you wish. One thing that we can do is find the number of days between two dates. To do this, let's create two new dates. In a third cell, let's just subtract our more recent date from our older one, and this will tell us the number of days in between these two, which is quite a useful feature for many applications. Within Microsoft Excel, we can also use our dates as a conditional formatting. So, let's say we want to check if a date is before or after another date. Well, we can call an if function, and that will take in a conditional statement and give us a result if the conditional statement is true, and the other if it is false. Therefore, through checking if this date is earlier than the other date, we can print whether it's past or future, like so. That's a quick overview of how to use the date function in Microsoft Excel. We've covered the basic syntax, formatting dates, calculating date differences, and conditional formatting using dates. I hope that this video helped you learn something about the date function within Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, or consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.